Hello everyone. In previous session, we discussed about introduction of Hamilton cycle and how to solve Hamilton cycle using a backtracking method. Today, I am going to start a new concept called Hamilton cycle problem. Today, I will discuss about how to solve a Hamilton problem using a backtracking method. Before going to start a problem, let's discuss about what is the introduction of Hamilton cycle in a brief. A Hamilton path is a path in an undirected graph that visits each vertex exactly once. A Hamilton cycle is a cycle in an undirected graph that visits each vertex exactly once and returns to the starting vertex. This is the main definition for Hamilton cycle. In today's class, we are discussing about a problem, how to solve a Hamilton cycle problem using a backtracking method. Yes, first I will take, this is the graph of Hamilton cycle given, and by seeing this graph we have to draw the matrix. Now if you go 1 to 1, what is the value 1 to 1? There is no edge between 1 to 1, so we have to put 0. If the edge between 1 to 2, next is 1 to 2, there is an edge between 1 to 2, so we have to put 1. Next edge between 1 to 3. 1, 2, 3. Yes, it is 1. We have to put 1. Next, 1, 2, 4. There is no edge between 1, 2, 4. So, we have to put 0. Next, there is edge between 1 to 5. Yes, it is there. You have to put 1. Similarly, next, we have to go for 2. 2 to 1. Yes, it is there. Edge 1. 2 to 2. Self loop. There is no self loop. So, we have to put 0. Similarly, we have to do this matrix. And after draw this matrix, next go for how to solve a Hamilton problem. Yes, before going to start a problem, there are three constraints in this problem to follow these rules. First rules, don't take a duplicate method. Second rule, there is a take an edge between neighboring nodes. Next third, you have to verify the answer of Hamilton cycle of a end of the position and go for the starting position. These are the three constraints you have to follow in this problem. Yes, before going to start, now we have to draw a matrix. Sorry, we have to draw an array of size 5. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is an array size. Call the name X. Now, initially, all the values should be, in Hamilton cycle problem, we have to start initially, all will be 0. We have to initialize 0 for all the array, all the position. Now, start any of the vertices. I will start with first vertices 1. Now, first vertices should be replace 0 with 1. This is 1. Clear? Next. After 1, go for next position. Listen carefully, this is very important question for examination point of view. After first position, let's go for second position. In second position, again we have to start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that only. Replace 0 and go for 1. If you put 1, it's already there. We can't put 1. Next, go for 2. Clear? Yes. Now, after 2, now we have to check the edge between 1 and 2. How to check? Here 1 is there, edge 1 to 2. Is there edge? Yes, it is there edge. Then it is a correct Hamilton cycle. So we have to start with 1 and edge is 2. Clear? Next, after 2, go for third position. Replace 0. Now we have to put 1. No, it's already there. 2, no. Next we go for 3. Now we have to check the edge between 2 to 3. See here, 2 to 3 is there. Yes, 3. Next go for 4th position. Now 1, no. 2, no. 3, why? Already is there in all the position. First three position. Next go for 4 only. Place here. Now 3 to 4, there is an edge, yes, so we have to put 4. Next, go for last position. 1 no, 2 no, 3 is there, 4 is there, only remaining is 5. Check, 4 to 5, there is an edge, 4 to 5, yes, it is there. 5. This is one solution. In Hamilton cycle, we'll get more than one solution. Now we'll get the one solution. How you will verify this solution is correct or not? Yes, see here. After getting this one, five, go for first position. Check. There is an edge between 5 to 1. 5 to 1. Yes, there is an edge between 5 to 1. Then it is the 100% solution is good. 100% this answer is correct. This is the one of the solution for Hamilton cycle. Similarly, we have to solve the Hamilton cycle. We will get another one solution in this problem by using a backtracking method. How it will be? Yes, listen here. Now, after getting this one, now we have to similarly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 after 0, they again 1, 2 like this we have to do. Correct? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After 5, what is the value? After 5, we have to put 0 here. Correct? After 0, backtrack the method. We have to backtrack the method. Clear? Now, after 0, go for 4. After 4, what is the value? After 4, what is the value? 5. Now we have to check for 5. There is an edge between 3 to 5. 3 to 5. No, there is no edge between 3 to 5. We can't go. Again, we have to remove this one. Again, remove. We have to put 0. Next, after this. 3. After 3, what is the value? 4 is there. Remove this one. 4 is there. We have to put the value 4. Now we have to check the value of 2 to 4. 2 to 4. Yes, it is there. The edge between 2 to 4 is there. So we have to put 4. After 4, now we have to go for again 4. What is the value here? 0 is there. Next, go for. Remove this one. We get the value backtracking method. Why you are doing? We are getting the value of a backtracking method. After getting this backtracking method, 4. Next, go for next procedure. Next, 4 afterwards, 5. Now, we have to check the value for 4 to 5. Sorry. After getting this 1, after getting this 4, now we have to check for 1 is there. Yes. 2 is there. Yes. 3 is not there. Now we have to go for 3. Clear? After 3, we'll check 4 to 3. 4 to 3. Yes, it is there. Edge between 4 to 3. Now we have to put 3. After 3, remove this one. Come again. 1 is there. 2 is there. 3 is there. Only remaining is 5. Now we have to check the value between 3 to 5. Here, 3 to 5. There is no edge. 3 to 5. So we have to kill this node and go back. Next. After 5, again we have to place this as a 0. Clear? After this, we have to place this as a 0. Next. Remove this one. After 4, what is the value? After 4, now we have to check for 5. Clear? What is the value? 4 to 5. 4 to 5. Yes, there is an edge. Clear? We'll get the value. 4 to 5. There is an edge. After this, 5. Next, go for this one. 5. 1 is there. 2 is there. 3 is not there. So, we have to put 3. Now, we have to check the value for 5 to 3. There is no edge. So, we have to kill this node. 5 to 3 is not there. Go back. Clear? Next. Again, you have to put the value as a 0. And 0. Next, we have to go for this condition. Next, we have to move for 5. Next, this is also 5 is there. So, we can't put 0. Clear? Next, after 0. Next, go for this condition. 4. Now we have to check the value for this position. How it's already 4 is there. After 4, what is the value? Five. Clear? 2 to 5. Now we have to check for 2 to 5. See here? 2 to 5 is there. Yes, it is the position is there. Next, after 5, come this position. It's 0. Now we have to change this one. 1 is there, 2 is there, next remaining is 3. Clear? Now 5 to 3. 5 to 3. There is no edge. So we can't put. Clear? Now rub this one. Next. 3 after 3. 4. 5 to 4. 5 to 4. Yes, there is an edge. So we have to put 4. This is 4. Now come this side. Last position is 0. Check. 1 is count. 2 is also we are not putting. Only 3 is remaining. Now we have to check the value for 4 to 3. Yes, 4 here. 4 to 3. 4 to 3 is 1. This is edge between 4 to 3 is there. Next, this is the one solution. How you will verify this solution is correct or not? After 3, this is 3. Next, go for the first position. Check. If there is any edge between 3 to 1, then the solution is good. Now we have to check for 3 to 1. 3 to 1. Yes, there is an edge. So this is one solution and this is one solution. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One solution and remaining 1, 2, 5, 4, 3. So 1, 2, 5, 4, 3. This is one solution and this is one solution. So this is very important question for examination point of view. These are all for the today's class. For upcoming sessions, we'll discuss about the coloring graph and we'll complete the module 5. So if you have any doubts and clarification regarding this problem, please message me in a comment box. For more updates, please subscribe my channel. Thank you, one and all.